It is a grave. It is a memorial. It is a piece of the nation's history. And it is also an underwater reef. But in March 1942, the Dixie Arrow was a tanker, steaming just offshore from the Outer Banks, loaded with fuel for the Allied war effort in Europe. A German U-boat was stalking the Dixie Arrow. The sub's torpedoes hit their mark, and the Dixie Arrow and 11 crew members went down in 90 feet of water.
You kind of get a snapshot into the past, into that piece of our nation's history. You're looking at it the way that it rests on the bottom of the ocean and has, perhaps, for the past 70 years, basically. So you really are getting a snapshot in time and back into history. And then also, they're amazing resources as far as being artificial reefs as well. I mean, they provide habitat for a lot of different creatures. So it's a beautiful experience, not only for the history, but also just to see what kind of life those resources now support.
The Dixie Arrow is now one of the shipwrecks that are the focus of a research project to locate and document with photos, videos, and maps the sea battle that raged off North Carolina's coast during World War II. It's called the Battle of the Atlantic Expedition.
They are non-renewable resources. They won't be around forever. So our goal is to go out and document them and to bring them to a public, too, that may not know that they exist at all. There's a great portion of the public that has no idea that World War II came this close to the United States, let alone to the North Carolina coast.
Maritime archaeologists working on the project estimate more than 60 wrecks of Allied ships, both merchant and Navy warships, as well as German U-boats, lie on the ocean floor within 100 miles of Cape Hatteras and Cape Lookout. The secret German plan called for a submarine assault on the American eastern seaboard. It was an area poorly defended and rich in merchant shipping targets. Through early 1942, U-boat crews struck at will, attacking in shallow water, then hiding in deeper water just off the continental shelf. So many merchant ships were sunk that captains referred to the area as Torpedo Junction. The Battle of the Atlantic was the closest place of combat to the U.S. during the war.
These shipwrecks are not only independent vessels, they have a relationship with each other. So, like the YP-389 was sunk by the U-701, and the U-701 lies off the coast of Cape Hatteras. They are intimately related.
And many are related to this. This is the wreck of the German submarine U-701. The German U-boat sank 9 Allied ships off the North Carolina coast. It was finally sunk in an Allied air and naval attack in 1942.
You're looking at a battlefield, an underwater battlefield, so you're not just learning the story of this specific shipwreck or the personal history or the story of the people that were associated with this wreck, but you're actually learning about that whole engagement that took place off the coast.
It is maritime detective work. Researchers want to not only document the wreck, what the ship is and where it is located, they are also looking at the condition of the wreck. The hull and other items made from steel and iron will eventually corrode and disintegrate. Objects made from non-ferrous metals, such as brass and bronze, will not corrode as easily.
So it allows us to look at those resources and see how they're changing over time, what is happening to them, how fast they are corroding, how long they may be around. And then, like I said, it also gives us a great opportunity to collect information on those resources and bring them to the public in different ways, through posters, through video, through photographs.
It's a different record set about history. We have history, we know what history means, we know about historical records. Historians know how to read them and interpret them and decipher them. Archaeological data can redefine our opinions about the past.
Researchers also hope information learned from the wrecks will help fill in the gaps in the historic record.
It's a test of history. It's often an insight into psychological states that maybe aren't reflected in historical records, so it augments historical records.
The Battle of the Atlantic Expedition is a joint effort between the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, the University of North Carolina Coastal Studies Institute, and East Carolina University.
For every hour on the expedition, we've planned, 10, 20 hours, we've done the right amount of planning, but there's a process of getting a group of people invested and then doing the work and seeing what you come out with, and sometimes that's successful and sometimes it's not.
Dive trips are meticulously planned. Divers don't have much time on the bottom, so they must work quickly and efficiently. Besides cameras, scientists utilize the latest technology to add to the historical record. This is a Towboat Magnetometer, which detects how a piece of iron, which has its own magnetic field, can disturb the Earth's magnetic field. It then uses that data to draw a picture of the item.
We have a particular mass of iron or steel or something. Say it's a cannon, an anchor, you can imagine. It's going to disturb that field. And what a magnetometer does is we tow it across a towpath, and it'll let us measure the degree of disturbance. And then we can map that. And then what we can do is then we can create contours. And then that's invariably something that's cultural. Could be a German U-boat. It could be an Allied freighter. It could be a cannon. Well, so this is a remotely operated vehicle, or an ROV. It has a camera in the front, right there, and these are lights here. You can see the thrusters here. This has the opportunity for a little grabber arm or an additional camera. And so it's a tethered camera that we can drive. But of course, the thing about archaeology is it's tangible. So much of history is about an intangible thing, a feeling, a psyche, a culture, and the tangible aspects of that are very alluring to people to see, touch, interact with the past directly. It brings history to a place where it actually happened. You can see it right there.
So there's a couple of things that make those wrecks memorable. It's the experience when you're diving on them, but it's also the stories behind them.